My name is Tom Dulaney. I'm 36 years old and I live in Arlington, Virginia. I have a developmental disability or condition called Asperger syndrome or autism spectrum. I was diagnosed before preschool. In those days, it was either pervasive developmental disorder, not otherwise specified. I'm in four groups for people with disabilities. Capernaum Beyond Club, which is a religious Christian group for people with cognitive, developmental, and intellectual disabilities. I'm in SPARC, Specially Adapted Resource Club. I'm in Autistic Association of Greater Washington. And I'm in Going Places for people with autism and other related conditions. It feels like I have a voice in the community, that I don't have to like hide in the closet, that I feel like I can just fit into society and stuff like that. I started out at special schools, but then middle school and high school, I started reattending Arlington public schools. I had a good experience. I had teachers who were very good with me along the way. The special schools were good, but my parents were thrilled when I started going back to Arlington public schools again. It felt a little funny when I first went into middle school in the seventh grade, but I kind of got used to it. I think it got much better in later adolescence. Early adolescence was a difficult time of being understood because I feel like early adolescence is probably the worst time for most youth. Yeah, I graduated from high school. I went to a job training program for 4 years from like 2002 to 2006. So 4 years in a job training program right after high school. I'm looking for a job right now, but I've held my last job for 12 and a half to 13 years, and I decided I wanted to try something new and different after 13 excellent years there. Anxiety and stress, yes. Maybe some depression because recently my dad passed away. Anxiety about, will I turn out okay? Will I make all the right choices? I mean, things could be worse, but they could be better at the same time. Sometimes I feel it when I get kind of lonely, but it's only like a borderline or a little pinprick. It's not something extreme. 2 years ago, it was torture because when I first moved into my own apartment, it was the first time I'd never lived with another person, and that was 2 years ago. It was a shock to my system because my whole life I had lived with at least someone from like the day I was born up until 2 years ago. So between 2 years ago and now, I really built myself up. Well, when it comes to navigating my emotions, I've had zero meltdowns since the day my dad died, and he died about 2 years and 4 months ago. I've been going to a counselor since a few months ago. I've been telling her about how things are going, my relationship with my brother and sister, and just how I'm hoping to play my cards right in life. I've been on medication since I was 8 years old, and I've been going to psychiatrists since I was 8 years old. But I started going to counseling for the first time since when my mother died last school year, but this calendar year that I currently go to. I think this is the second time I've been to a counselor. The first time was only temporary, and that was when my mother died. Yeah, it helped me spill out my feelings and stuff like that. But I was a much different person when I went to counseling this time around than when I went to counseling 19 years ago. I had a normal childhood. We grew up in a house of five people, you know, my mom, dad, brother, sister, and me, and we were a happy family. I had a pretty normal childhood. 2 years ago, at the same time, I was having to start my life all over again. My dad had just died about 4 months earlier at the same time 2 years ago, and I feel like Nancy, Merle, and Ben and my uncle helped me start life all over again. I had to look for a new place to live and stuff like that. They're really pulling for me. They're proud of me for trying new things, even though I've been going marching into the unknown. I feel like some families, they're more privileged than we are, because in the immediate family, both our parents had died. And I feel like my dad did an excellent job helping all three of us the first 17 years after our mother died. I remember everything my dad taught me the first 17 years after my mother died. And I feel like even though his mission to raise us was successful, it wasn't complete. But I've been remembering what he taught me. I had other people showing me the way and stuff like that. So at the end, there was light at the end of my tunnel. I feel like we're often misunderstood. One of my fears is that I feel like some people might mistake me for being lazy, unmotivated, or someone who's just not trying hard enough. Occasionally with supervisors, and I have a friend who really has my best interest at heart, but she thinks I could try much harder than I really am, even though I know I'm trying. Basically, I was born with an invisible condition. Recognize the signs and know what you're seeing, especially if they have a condition that's hard to see or understand like mine, like a subtle one. Take the time to get to know them and find out where they're coming from. That way you'll know what you're seeing when dealing with someone with disabilities and mental health problems. Because I want them to have all the advantages that I might possibly might not have had.